When discussing theories for the origin of aliens, we've always taken into consideration the extraterrestrial hypothesis. But I believe stronger weight ought to be given to the interdimensional possibility. We can, in fact, speak in terms of these other dimensions or higher levels of existence by thinking of them as an apartment building.
The theory hinges on the idea that there are any number of universes or dimensions existing in parallel. In his theory, humans are merely tenants of an apartment building and occupy one floor. Let's say it's the second floor. This is our reality. And on all the other floors live very different tenants. Perhaps the Bigfoots are on the third floor. And above them are the Chupacabras. We all live in the same apartment building, just on different floors.
Now, we can possibly come into contact with these other tenants of our interdimensional apartment building whenever we meet them in common areas.
These common areas act as portals between dimensions in places like the lobby, the stairwell, or the elevator. Places that all of the apartment building's tenants would use.
Notice that all of human legends seem to speak of places that are accursed, haunted. It varies from culture to culture, from country to country, but the fact that there are places where one can actually make contact with these denizens of other realities is a fact.
Although probably not a fact that would stand up in court. Nonetheless, Corrales is firm in his conviction that one of these common areas is the El Yunque rainforest in Puerto Rico. And with over 28,000 acres, there's a lot of room for a chupacabra to hide. Corrales believes that the forest acts like a portal, and that the chupacabra isn't the only thing that comes through it.
As far as we're concerned, we know that UFOs have regularly manifested themselves at El Yunque. We know that human disappearances, ranging from your individual backpackers, casual people just stepping off a mountain path and never being seen again, date back to the 1960s, perhaps even the 1950s.
But perhaps hiding under all this paranormal mist is yet another explanation for the chupacabra. And all the signs lead directly to Uncle Sam. In 1995, the Chupacabra and its UFO connections put Puerto Rico on the extraterrestrial map. But there is one man who believes that El Chupacabra is very much homegrown. Orlando Pla is a longtime UFO and paranormal researcher living in Puerto Rico. In his mind, all things strange and bizarre on this island point to the US military.
When I go out to investigate the Chupacabra phenomenon, I first point my finger downward, and I first look for military and secret operations before pointing my finger up and saying, this comes from outer space.
To really get where Orlando's coming from, you need a crash course in Puerto Rican history. In the Spanish-American War of 1898, Puerto Rico was annexed by the US. But then in 1952, it got some independence. Just not enough to stop the Pentagon from making it a home away from home. At its peak, the US military had no less than 25 installations across the island.
There is a very, very close relation between the military and Puerto Rico. Even when you go to El Yunque, you cannot enjoy the full capacity of all that El Yunque has to offer, because 75% of El Yunque is controlled by the military.
Orlando believes that many of the bizarre phenomena that occur on this island can be explained by this massive military presence, and that Puerto Rico is being used as a big petri dish for American experiments. By law, the CIA cannot conduct operations inside the United States, but Puerto Rico is still considered an international territory. And as far as Orlando is concerned, the CIA were up to some pretty sinister things.
They can do whatever they want in the island. Back in the 50s, without making any precautions, without telling anybody, they started experimenting with contraceptive agents on the Puerto Rican women.
This is true. Puerto Rican women were given birth control pills that were still highly experimental, and basically, they were used as guinea pigs. But that's not all.
Back in the 60s, El Yunque had experiments with the notorious Agent Orange.
This is also true. The jungles of Puerto Rico were very similar to Vietnam, and the US military wanted to see if their deforesting agent would work. But here's where it gets really interesting.
In World War II, the CIA created a mythical creature that would eat you alive and suck your blood so that the Japanese soldiers did not fight in the jungle.
And there's some truth in this one, too. When American troops were fighting in the Philippines, they heard the legend of something called the Aswag vampire. The US military exploited the vampire myth by draining the blood from killed soldiers and leaving their corpses on display to strike fear into the enemy. Orlando goes one step further. He believes that the CIA actually tried to create a blood-sucking monster. Orlando believes experiments actually took place and that the chupacabra is the result.
How do we know that a chupacabra attack or a mutilation attack is for real? Okay. We have to look at what is going on around the scene of the mutilation. When you start seeing government people around, when you start seeing the civil defense, when you start seeing SWAT teams, when you start seeing military personnel, when you start seeing search parties, you know that the attack is for real, that something very strange is happening, because the government is not going to invest thousands of dollars for a wild dog that entered the yard and killed a couple chickens.
The idea that the chupacabra is a CIA experiment that got out of control does seem a little improbable. The problem is that he's not the only one saying it. Even the sheriff of Canovanas believes that the CIA is up to something on the island.
Pero me incliné más a que era un experimento. Chupacabra es un experimento.
I am more inclined to believe that it is an experiment. The chupacabra is an experiment on some animal that got out of control. And what they created managed to escape. On many occasions, we have stayed on the lookout in the mountains, trying to find the chupacabra. And some people from the federal government would show up with dogs.
It is perhaps a little suspicious that a sheriff wouldn't be allowed to run training exercises in his own country's largest national park.